Let's start getting familiar with the PyWeb API in one of the most common HTTP clients out there, Google Chrome. If you're using the default self-signed certificate, when you're opening the base URL for the PyWeb API through a browser, it can be reached with the fully qualified machine name, followed by a slash, and then PyWeb API. Again, I just want to reiterate that vnets.holtz.dev is a personal test system, and you won't be able to connect to it from your machine. When attempting to reach this page, it will request our credentials so we can authenticate. Once we're authenticated, we arrive at the main landing page. One thing I'd like to point out is the link to the help pages in the upper left-hand corner. If you're new to the PyWeb API, it is beneficial to visit these to get started. In the main part of the page, you can also see the list of links to different resources in JSON format. We can view our data servers, asset servers, as well as the overall system configuration. Since the PyWeb API is a RESTful interface and therefore stateless, no client information is stored on the server in between requests. So if we make two requests to the PyWeb API, the second request is completely independent of the first. Other characteristics include the fact that all resources are identified by URLs. All we need to know is the correct URL in order to properly find the resource or information that we're looking for. For example, if we click on the data servers link on the landing page, we'll find that this brings us to a new page with a new URL and shows us the data servers resources. We can see multiple data servers are reachable by this PyWeb API instance. The resources exposed by the PyWeb API are connected via links. So when you're building your client application, you don't necessarily need to construct URLs, but rather you can go one resource to the next and navigate through the links. Let's take a look at the system link. The system link allows you to take a look at the configuration information for the PyWeb API instance you're currently connected to. For example, if we select the user info endpoint, we can see the currently connected user. If we select the version endpoint, we can see the version of the PyWeb API that we're currently connected to. If we select the configuration endpoint, we can see the configuration information on the PyWeb API instance that we're currently connected to, including what authentication methods are allowed, among other things. We'll be revisiting some of these configuration parameters in later videos. Other resources you may be more interested in are the data servers, or the PyData archive links, as well as the asset servers, or AF server links. When we click on the data server link, we can see that we have two PyData archives. If we select the self link, we can also see some basic information about that server as well, such as the name and the server version. Again, it's worth noting that in this particular test system, the PyWeb API and the data archive are on the same machine, so they happen to have the same name in this particular setup. From here, we can use the links to navigate to find information specific to this specific data archive. Let's click on the points resource link. This brings us to a page with all of the points configured for this PyData archive. If we use Ctrl F, we can search on this page for a specific tag. Let's search for the sinusoid tag. We can see some basic configuration information about the sinusoid tag here, such as its point ID and what type of tag it's configured as. Much like the data archive resource, each point has a set of resource links that we can use to find additional information. For example, if we click on the value link, we're brought to a page which displays the current value of the sinusoid tag with the snapshot time, along with the typical event information, such as if it's marked questionable or substituted. One thing to note, the PyWeb API represents all timestamps as UTC, whereas my client machine is located in UTC-4, so we see the timestamp is a bit different than our current machine time. let's see what other information we can gather about this tag. If we click on the interpolated data, it will bring us to a new page. Here, we see it brings up a number of values with exactly 1 hour intervals. Without any additional information provided to it, the PyWeb API assumes some defaults to make this interpolated data call. It will provide interpolated values every hour from 24 hours ago until now. The recorded and plot data have similar properties that we'll explore in later videos. If we navigate back to the home page and then to the asset service link, we see we get similar information to when we navigated to the data archive. If we select the self link, we can see the name and server versions here as well. However, this time, instead of listing out the points, we have the option to list out the databases on the IF server. We can see our configuration database, as well as our new green database. Within these databases, we have the option to list the elements in the database. You'll notice that this current list is only a list of the root elements on the database. If we want to go down further in the AF hierarchy, we'll need to select the elements on that root elements. Once we've found an element of interest, we can list the attributes on this element. When we do this, we see additional information about each attribute configured for this element. We can see the configuration for this particular AF attribute, and see that it's configured as a PyPoint data reference, and as such, we can take a look at the archive data for this attribute. In this video, we got our first real look at the PyWeb API. We used a browser, in my case Google Chrome, to take a look at the PyWeb API. We saw that the PyWeb API is a series of URLs that return information and links to other resources in JSON format. Because the PyWeb API returns links to other resources, we don't necessarily need to know the exact URL for the resource we need for our information in our applications. We can often take advantage of the PyWeb API's links to other resources in order to locate what we might need. We saw that we can query for information on the PyWeb API itself, such as the configuration parameters and what authentication methods we're using to connect. We can query for information on the data archives, such as what points they have and the values for those points. Similarly, for the PyAF server, we're able to navigate through the hierarchy to see information about elements, attributes, and the values of those attributes. I'd recommend taking a few minutes to click around in the PyWeb API in a browser and get comfortable with the general structure of the linking to other resources before moving on to the next video.